Welcome to this first episode of a series of videos showcasing new features of Amazon Lex. My name is Thomas Rinfus. I'm a Senior Solutions Architect on the Amazon Lex team. And today I will cover a few recently released features. We will cover setting session attributes to enable and disable voice and DTMF input. We will use these and the advanced retry settings to configure a DTMF only slot. We will also cover how to configure prompt variations to be played in order to allow you to configure different prompts for the initial prompt and retry prompts. This bot is based around the book trip example bot. So you can create your own bot and start with an example and choose book trip. The book trip bot has a book hotel intent. Let's switch to the new visual builder to get a better view of the conversational design. I'll put a link in the description of this video to the blog that covers the new visual builder. Here, we can edit the slot for collecting the check-in date. Click this icon to get into the prompt advanced settings. Here, you'll find an option called Play the Messages in Order. This allows you to specify your retry prompts in your message group. I have an initial prompt, a retry prompt with some additional information, and a DTMF fallback prompt, where I tell the customer how to enter the data using DTMF. If I select Configure Advanced Retry Settings, I am presented with additional options for my initial Retry 1 and Retry 2 prompts. Here, I can specify if I want the prompt to be audio and DTMF, audio only, or DTMF only for each prompt. Here, I've integrated the bot with an Amazon Connect contact flow. I've selected the bot and the alias, and you can see that we can also use session attributes to configure the DTMF and voice behavior. In this case, I've set both allow DTMF input and allow voice input to true. The documentation details how you can set these values for voice and chat for specific intents and slots or the entire bot. Let's call in and try it out with the current configuration.
Welcome to Octank Travel and Hospitality. How can we help you today?
I want to book a hotel.
What city will you be staying in?
New York.
What day do you want to check in?
Hedgehog. I'm saying hedgehog here to force the bot to retry eliciting the slot.
What day do you want to check in? You can say things like tomorrow, next Monday, or January 14th.
Hedgehog.
Please enter the date you want to check in using 4-digit year, 2-digit month, and 2-digit day. How many nights will you be staying?
4 nights.
What type of room would you like? Queen, king, or deluxe?
Deluxe.
Okay, I have you down for a 4-night stay in New York starting September 20, 2022. Shall I book the reservation?
Yes.
Would you also like to book a car?
No.
Thank you for calling Octank Travel and Hospitality. Goodbye.
Now, in this case, we also showcase the conditional statement where we collect the go to book car. We ask, do you want to book a car? And we can easily here in the designer have a conditional branch where we check to see if the value of the go to book car slot value was yes or not. If I had said yes, we would have continued with the closing statement saying, let's get you a car, and then sent it on to the book car intent to continue booking a vehicle. Now, in Amazon Connect, we can update the session attributes. We'll keep the DTMF to true, but we'll set the voice option here to false. Now let's test this again, now that voice has been disabled specifically for the get check-in date intent. Before I call in, I'll update the voice prompts to not ask for voice input, since that has been disabled. I'll set all three prompts to just ask for DTMF input.
Welcome to Octank Travel and Hospitality. How can we help you today?
I want to book a hotel.
What city will you be staying in?
Los Angeles.
Please enter the date you want to check in using 4-digit year, 2-digit month, and 2-digit day.
October 22nd. Note that it won't take this voice input since we've disabled voice.
Please enter the date you want to check in using 4-digit year, 2-digit month, and 2-digit day. How many nights will you be staying?
3 nights.
What type of room would you like? Queen, king, or deluxe?
Queen.
Okay, I have you down for a 3-night stay in Los Angeles starting October 22nd, 2022. Shall I book the reservation?
Yes. This time, we had disabled the voice option for the check-in date slot. That's why it wouldn't accept my attempts to speak the check-in date. Entering it using my phone's dial pad worked fine, since the DTMF input was still set to true. If you are using voice input, and you'd like to disable barge-in, you also have the option of doing that by setting the allow interrupt to false. The default behavior is true. Today, we went through how to use session attributes to enable and disable voice and DTMF inputs, as well as control barge-in behavior. There are additional attributes that can be used to configure timeout values, max allowed DTMF digits, and utterance length for voice. We showed how these attributes could be used to configure a slot as a voice or DTMF only slot. We also covered how to configure the message variations in order to provide separate initial retry 1 and retry 2 messages. For more information, please refer to the documentation pages. Thank you for spending a few minutes learning about these new features. I encourage you to see how these features can improve the customer experience in your contact center.